Flosstube, it's Paula. Welcome to my channel, Stitching in High Heels. This is a channel where on YouTube where I talk about crafting, mostly cross stitch, occasionally some crochet, and some life updates here and there sprinkled in. If you're new, welcome. I hope you like what you see. If you do, please press subscribe. Wow, having trouble talking already. Yes, please press subscribe. If you're returning, thank you so much. I appreciate having you all here. And I know it's been a while since we chatted, so there's lots to talk about, and let's kind of dive right in. It's Wednesday evening, October 7th. I'm going to blame any foolishness and difficulty speaking on the fact that I worked all day today in my office, had an hour commute each way, and the fact that this is actually take three on episode 12 of Stitching in High Heels. I tried to record twice this weekend and somehow ended up without any video on my phone. So, here we go. I've got a bunch of FFOs, a couple of starts, finishes, and FFO'd items all since we've spoken last. A few FFOs, which are fully finished objects for those of you who are new. Items that I had stitched previously. And then I've got some WIPs, or works in progress, and some stash to share with you all, some plans, and at the very end we'll have a giveaway. So, here we go. This first piece is a piece that I know I had stitched before. I can't find it, so I stitched it again. It's called Nuts About Autumn from Waxing Moon Designs. And here it is. I started it, finished it, and FFO'd it. Let's see, I think you can get a good picture of it there. I stitched it on what I saw, a scrap of fabric. I'm pretty sure it's 16 count Fiddler's Light Aida. It's stitched with two threads over one square of Aida. I did put the Just Another Button buttons, these little acorns, if you can see them there, and put them on. It's stitched, the chart calls for all, I think Gentle Arts floss, but overdyed flosses. I used the ones that I had and used a couple of DMC substitutes where I didn't have them. And it's finished on these two squirrels that I got last year at Michael's. You can see their little faces here. They're each holding an acorn. I'd actually hoped that, and here we go, here's the other guy. They're just a little bit different, just slightly different. There we go. I had really hoped that one of them was going to be enough to finish it. I had an idea that I could make it look like he was holding this little banner. And the piece turned out to be too big. So I did kind of hot glue them to the squirrels, but it'll be easy to remove if I don't. The other thing that I'm quite happy with is this bow. I don't know if you can see it on the top there. I'm not good at making bows, and I took an idea from, I believe it's Yellow House Crafts. She took pieces of ribbon. Let me see if I can hold it here and show you. She took pieces of ribbon, kind of fancy cut them on the end there like that. And this would probably show up a little better if I had put a contrasting layer in there, like maybe a piece of white lace or something. But it's three layers of ribbon, gathered them together in the middle, put a little piece of ribbon around it, and glued it on the top. It's probably the best looking bow I've ever made. And back, here we go again. This is the whole piece. So, let's see if I can get it all in there. Pretty happy with this. Kind of came out pretty much exactly how I had envisioned, except it is a little bigger than what I thought. So it's Nuts About Autumn. I don't think I mentioned the designer. It's Waxing Moon Designs. And I believe you can get a PDF of the chart on her Etsy site. I have the paper chart. I bought it quite a while ago at my LNS. Like I said, I'm pretty sure I had already stitched that at some point, but I can't find the finished piece. And it was a really quick stitch. The second FFO is another piece that I had already stitched. And again, I couldn't find the stitched piece. But this is JBW Designs. This is Country French Pumpkin. And this pillow I purchased, JBW Designs. She used to work with a company that produced these pillows for her. And it came, there's a pillow form inside, but it came with the pillow cover and the buttons to hold the pieces on. So I bought this then. I had stitched the design. And again, I couldn't find the finished piece of stitchery. So I had another piece of Relic, and I bought some fall colored silken colors by Thread Gatherer. And the one that I used was Rusty Amber, which is a real nice piece. It's on a piece of, I believe, 32 count Relic by Picture This Plus. And I followed the finishing directions from JBW Designs. So if you can see here, you take a piece of backing fabric. I use just this piece with little leaves on it. You sew them together, right sides together, put a slit in the back, and then you turn it right side out, press it a little bit, trim the seams, and then you sew it on with these four buttons. So I haven't been able to find any more of these pre-made pillow forms, but now that I see one, I've got a good idea. I think I can probably do one myself. And if you've seen Brendan the Serial Starter, she talked about how easy covered buttons are to do. And my dog just knocked the camera, sorry about that. But I do have stuff to do these. So I have another piece that I'd like to finish like this, another JBW Designs. So I have an idea for making the pillow and making covered buttons to match. So I should be able to replicate this. Okay, let's try this again. My phone cut out there for a few minutes. So hopefully I'll find that you saw everything about my JBW Designs pillow. Another FFO that I have is this one. It's called October Feast by Brenda Gervais. Let's see if you can get a good picture of it there. Cute little squirrel. I finished this in a tarte pan with a wooden base. I got that from Homestead Needleworks. I'll show you her card later. I have another one. She's a shop on Etsy. I think her name was Sarah. I'll mention it when I show you the new piece that I got. Put a little 2020 charm on here. Have a bunch of those for pieces I stitched in 2020. I did stitch this one last year. I think you used a combination of the called for threads and the DMC substitutions that I picked myself. It's on a piece of 16 count Aida, two threads over one. Again, October Feast by With Thy Needle and Thread. And just in this real cute little chart pan. Tarte pan, excuse me. I used Vonna Pfeiffer's tutorial for finishing these. Her instructions are really great. I don't remember if this was a video tutorial or one from her blogs with pictures. In any case, her tutorials are really easy to follow, and I'll link it below. And then my last three finishes are all Jeanette Douglas pieces. The first one is, and I apologize, I forget the name of this piece, but it's, she did a seasonal set of seasonal smalls, and this is the winter one. I initially got this as a club piece from Silver Needles, a little help from our friends circle, and it's since been released, but I got it as a kit. So used all the called for threads and the called for fabric. I think it's 32 count raw linen, maybe. I might be wrong. I know it's 32 count. I might have the name of it wrong. So it's stitched with the called for threads And I did pretty much everything as called for, except if you can see these berries here, and also up here. I did those as Smyrna crosses, just to mix it up a little bit. I thought it kind of the specialty stitches kind of went with the little bit of specialty down here. And then I finished it as a pillow. This is the backing fabric, just a piece of fabric I picked up at Joann's, but I really like how it goes with the piece. I stuffed it with polyfill, and then it was puffier than I liked, so I used the steam setting on my iron and I pressed it a little bit flatter. I do have some chenille to go around this. It's with the chart, which unfortunately I can't put my hands on right now. It's one of two places. So I probably will add the chenille around this. My plan is to stitch a couple more smalls, Christmas smalls, finish them as pillows like this, and then I have a real pretty footed bowl. Put some small Christmas like glass or plastic balls in there, and then settle the some of these stitched smalls in with it. Should be a pretty display. And I apologize that I can't remember the name of this chart, but it was released, I believe, the beginning of this year. And again, it's a Jeanette Douglas piece. I'll try to find the name of it and link it below. And these last two are from just, they're Jeanette Douglas. She did a series of needle roll ornaments for the, I think it was 2003, 2004, 2005, and 2006 issues. This first one is Peace. Let's see if you can get a good look at that. Blue and white. It's got some, these are beads here. I don't know if you can see that real well, if it's showing up real well on the camera. And it's, I believe it's a 32 count piece of fabric. Back in 2003 and 2004, Silk Weaver, before the guys in New Jersey took it over, they would do ornament cuts for ornaments in the Just Cross Stitch ornament issue, whether it was their own hand-dyed fabric or standard fabrics. I think this is a standard Zweigart. I have to say the finishing instructions in the magazine for these are really, they make it really easy. So you count up a certain number of threads and you pull out three threads. I don't know if you can see that there. And then you roll over the remaining and you just do a quick hem stitch, and that finishes off both the top and the bottom. And then I ran a quick straight seam down the back with my sewing machine. And then you count up, I think it's 24 threads from the top of the design and the bottom of the design. You pull out three more threads, and I just wove this is just a standard white, I believe it's 1/8 inch ribbon that came on a spool, and you can get it at Michael's, Hobby Lobby, Joann. And you weave that through, pull the ends together and around the stuffing. This is also stuffed with polyfill. Let me see if you can get a give you a better look at the front of that again. For some reason, I think my camera angle's a little bit odd. But this one is Peace. And I think this was the 2004 ornament. And then this one is Love. It's red and white. Use the same process to finish it. This one probably was the 2003 ornament. Not sure if you can see it there, but it's on a piece of white opalescent fabric. There's a little bit of sparkle with it. Again, I think it's just a plain piece of 32 count opalescent white Belfast. And this is a little bit of a metallic red ribbon that I got. Again, one of those that you get on the spool, Michael, Joann's, wherever. So that's, and that's the last of my FFOs, or fully finished objects. So I had two start finish FFOs, which was Nuts About Autumn and Country French Pumpkin. These all other ones were all previously stitched. I don't have any other finishes. I was really good and didn't start anything new. But I did touch several of my WIPs or works in progress. If I use an abbreviation and you don't recognize it, if you're new here, definitely shoot me a comment or an email. Ask me what it is. I try to remember to explain. Some of these terms have been around the cross-stitch world since I found the online stitching world in, probably the late 1990s, right before 2000. In the old AOL boards, the Teresa Wentzler board, that was kind of where I learned all these terms. And I know as a newbie, I was kind of hesitant to ask sometimes, so I kind of had to read between the lines to figure out what they were. So definitely ask me. We don't mean to exclude people, but occasionally there are terms that are just so natural to us, we don't even think about it. So on to WIPs. And trying to find my piece of mat board here. I'm sorry. Here it is. Okay. So the first one that I have to share with you, this is the piece that I stitch on at work at the 911 center when the phones aren't busy. It's easy to take with me. This is, let me see if I can show you without a whole lot of glare, because that's an actual photograph there. This is Return of the Whales by Chessie and Me. This was also a Circle of Friends from the Silver Needle Club piece. I'm not sure if this has been released, if it will be released. I have a feeling since Jeanette Douglas released hers, this one probably will be eventually. And I do apologize ahead of time. I haven't ironed anything. But here's where I'm at with this. So I'm finished all the way over to this side here, and now I'm working on this big hill over here, which feels like it's never ending. It comes out about 2 stitches past the widest branch on this tree here, and then there is one more dark green tree, and then there's a border around it, which is it's stitched in red. The chart calls for 4-sided stitches. I'm not sure if I'm going to do them or if I'm going to do just cross stitch. We'll see how I feel when I get there. I don't hate 4-sided stitches, just think they may take a little bit longer than cross stitch, but we'll see. It is stitched on 32 count Ren, which is the suggested fabric from Picture This Plus, with all the called for weeks and Gentle Arts threads. The cover shows it finished as a pin pillow. And we did get a set of Just Another Button Company pins with it. I'm thinking I may actually finish this into a drum. See how much fabric I have left over, but I think I can do it without it being too narrow to look right. I think it'll look fine. So I'm thinking about finishing this into a pin drum. Drums and strawberries I'm kind of obsessed with right now. Not that I've actually made one yet, mind you, but I've got a bunch of pieces in progress that I think I want to finish that way. So let me know what you think, pin pillow or pin drum. I'll be anxious to hear what your opinions are. Let me see if I can center this a little bit better. So trying to get the light good. It's night, it's dark. It's usually daylight when I film, so things may look a little bit wonky tonight, and if they do, I apologize. But here it is. Again, Return of the Whales by Chessie and Me. I'm not sure if I said it's one thread, one strand of floss over 2 threads. So it's coming along. Hopefully I'll have a finish on that one before too long. Sorry, I had to set that back down there. It all depends on how busy it is at the 911 center and how much schoolwork I've got to do. So the next piece I have, this isn't a new piece, it's been out there for a while. It's a Plum Street Samplers piece, and again, I'm hoping there's not too much glare. I know the lights are kind of crazy in here tonight. But this is Cinnamon Stars, and I started this piece along with Laura from Stitching by the Shore. If you're not watching her, please go ahead and check her out. I will link her channel below. She's working on a lot of really cool pieces. I like her color choices. She's really good at changing up fabrics and and even threads. She stitches primarily in DMC, and her work is just lovely. And I enjoy her video. I love watching her video. She usually films on Fridays. Last week she took a week off. She posted a notice that she wasn't going to be putting a video up. But I started this with her. Let me put my mat board behind it. She's also stitching this on a piece of yellowish material, different than mine. I think hers is called Honey Amber, and I think it's a Bestitch Me fabric. I'm not completely positive about that. This is 32 count Moonglow Belfast by Picture This Plus. I'm using a combination of the Called For Gentle Arts and Weeks threads, and where I didn't have them, I went with the DMC substitutions. So, and I think really with this piece, the only place that you might notice a difference is the center part of the house here. You can see mine's kind of variegated. I believe it's sage. I think it might be a Weeks Dyeworks colored. I'm not sure on the manufacturer. I know the color is sage, and I think you can see that mine's a little variegated. So if you use the DMC, you wouldn't get any of that change in color, but it still would be perfectly pretty. Everything else on here, honestly, everything, the stars and everything, there's so few stitches together. I really don't see that it would make a difference whether you're using DMC or an overdyed. So I'm out here. This is almost the edge of the piece. I think a couple, there's going to be some flowers along the fence here. And I think a couple leaves come over a little bit further. But I'm almost at the right edge of the piece. I want to get the flowers in here, and there's some stars up in here. The house kind of straddles the two pages of the chart. So I want to get this side finished, and then I'll move over and finish the other side. But again, Cinnamon Stars by Plum Street Samplers. Two threads, two strands of floss over two fabric threads on 32 count Moonglow Belfast by Picture This Plus. Next up is, this is an older piece. The copyright on this is 2004, and I'm pretty sure I bought it right about when it came out, and it's called Renaissance by Paw Prince Designs. Really pretty band sampler. I love the blues. The model was stitched on 32 count antique white Belfast using NPI silks. But there is a DMC substitution provided in the chart, and I'm stitching it in DMCs. This is either ivory or antique white Jobelin. I believe it's Jobelin. It doesn't feel like Lagana. It's a little smoother, has a little bit of give to it with the little bit of synthetic that is in Jobelin. So when I stitched this top piece, all these little individual motifs are backstitched. And I debated about whether I was going to do the back stitching or not. And I did one, and it made a difference. So I went on and I did them all. But then I got down here into the fleur-de-lis, and I decided I wasn't going to do the back stitching there. And then I didn't do the back stitching on this row cross stitch either. And the lighting's a little weird, so it might be hard to see that light blue stitching in here on the lower side of these motifs. It shows up just fine in person. And I think I'm going to skip the back stitching on that. So it's got some specialty stitches. If you can see these bands here, hopefully you can see that. Some of it's, white pearl cotton, and it shows up better in person than I think it's showing up here on the video. But my absolute favorite row so far is this blue and gold row here. If you can see it, that's rice stitch using two colors of thread. I'd never done it that way before, and I really like the effect. And the metallic, the chart called for a gold cord. I didn't have any of that, so either gold cord or Japan gold. I forget which one, but I do have number 4 braid in gold HL, and that's what I'm using. So again, this is Renaissance by Paw Printing Designs. Pretty happy with my progress there. I'm splitting time with this, this piece and the next one I'm going to show you. The weeks that I work from home, I'm still working from home every other week. And if I have conference calls, where I generally don't have to have my camera on, and some of them are rather lengthy, and I know you guys will understand having something to stitch, especially if it's something that's not heavy with confetti, if it's something that's fairly straightforward, kind of helps keep me focused on what's actually being discussed on the call. I'm sure none of the people I work with would understand that, but stitchers do. So I take advantage of that when I can, when I'm home, on those calls. So, like I said, I'm splitting time between Renaissance and this next piece by The Drawn Thread. This is another older piece. The copyright on this one is 2002. And this one is called, what is this called? An Open Heart. And it's another band sampler. It's a pretty long piece. This one I did with a group of friends. We did it as a round robin, which, if you're unfamiliar with that, that's when you put your fabric and your materials and your chart together, and a group of you, everybody does their own starts their own piece, and you send it, mail it around to each participant in the group in an order, and everybody stitches on part of the chart. So we did this one this way, and it came back to me. Part of my pile fell over there. Sorry, guys. This one came back to me with everything except the two outermost borders done. And it's been sitting, God, I can't tell you how long it's been sitting. I think it was a fairly new chart when we did it and we sent it around. There is no date on it. I'm sorry, I'm trying to take the Q-snap off the top here so I can show it to you. So when it came back to me, the only thing left to do is the outermost border. And it's rolled up on my Q-snap, so I'm trying to get you a good picture here. So if you can see that pale pink back stitching, and this, it's actually 739, but it looks almost like ecru. Those two borders are the only thing that was left to do. And this top part was started, the last person to work on it did start those. So I got it back out. I kind of want to get it done. And I've started, bear with me here a second. So I've started working on it. And if you can see, there's a row of cross stitches in the white work border. And I've got that down to here on both sides. And that's just a little over halfway. And now that that's done, then I'll go and I'll fill in all these satin stitches like what's here. And I'll fill that in the rest of the way down and do the back stitching and then move my Q-snaps again. So let me see if I can get you, wow, I don't know if I can come back far enough to show you at least the top half of this. But this is, it's a really pretty piece. This is a piece, it was also charted in NPIs and on linen. I chose a piece of even weave. I think this one is 32 count, probably Lagaina. It feels like it's all cotton. And I picked my own colors and did a DMC conversion. There's not one provided in the chart, but I just looked at I pulled the NPIs. I'm trying to get this back together here. Sorry, guys. I pulled the NPIs, or the list of NPIs, and then went online looking for conversions. And kind of looked at the DMCs and got the colors, picked colors that were close, colors that I liked, give the kind of the same tone of the piece, if you will. So I'm pretty happy with that. That'll be a fun thing to get finished and up on the wall. Not sure I'm going to finish that. I miscounted when I sent it out, so it started pretty close to the top of the fabric. So I may just finish that on my own as a bell pull, put kind of a sleeve on the back of it or some loops on the top to hang it, and do that rather than framing it. Seems like that may make more sense. So what have I got here? One more whip or work in progress. And this is Christmas at Hawk Run Hollow. And I'll move it closer here. I'm working on this square here, which is it's a peacock, and it's the words "I heard the bells on Christmas Day." So this chart is by Carriage House Samplings. The Hawk Run Hollow charts have been out for a while. I'm not sure what the copyright date on this one is, But I started this fairly recently. Pam from Stitching in the Land of Good Enough. She's got another great channel. If you're not watching her, please go check her out. She's a lot of fun. She works on some really cool pieces, including she's working on a year at Hawk Run Hollow. She's also taking part in WIPGO this year, which is a bingo-like game. She explains all that and how it's helping her get progress. The other really exciting thing, she's in the process of opening a brick-and-mortar needle workshop. I believe she said it's in North Attleboro, Massachusetts. So if any of you are in that area, she's just in the beginning phases. I think she's hoping to be open by November. I know they do have a lease on the space. She did an Instagram video and showed us the space with nothing in it and what her plans are. So she's working on that, which that'll be exciting. It's not very close to me, but, you know, it's one of those things. Maybe my husband and I can do an overnight sometime, take a drive up to Massachusetts, check out Pam's shop, do some other things in the area. So we'll see. But here's where I'm at. So anyway, how Pam ties into this. She's working on a year at Hawk Run Hollow, and it's been in progress for a while. She really wants to move it along and get some good progress on it. So she is hosting a Zoom Stitch Together every second and fourth Thursday of the month for anyone who's stitching any of the Hawk Run Hollow pieces. There's a few people that are stitching Halloween. I don't remember all of them. I know Sebastian from Bees and Tees Stitching here on YouTube is stitching Halloween. A couple other people are stitching Halloween. I think a couple people that have joined a couple times are stitching Shores at Hawk Run Hollow. I think somebody's working on the Village at Hawk Run Hollow. So there's a nice variety of the pieces. There's at least one other person working on Christmas that I know of. Everybody's got, you know, varying degrees of progress on it. Some of us started it just to work with Pam on this, and some people are further along. So here's where I am. This is the first square. Again, I started it when Pam started her stitch along back in, I don't know if it was July or August. So I'm using 20 count light oatmeal Aida. I admit I was a little intimidated by 40 count. I wasn't sure, excuse me, if I could see the threads. So I decided to do 20 count Aida. It's one floss thread over one square of Aida. I'm using the DMC conversion provided in the chart. And you can see how big this is going to be. I mean, this is 20 count Aida. And, you know, let's see if I can do this. Kind of, here's my hand. So that's how big it is. Each square is 92 stitches by 92 stitches. So it's pretty sizable. On 20 count, that works out to a little over 4 inches square. But for working on this only a couple nights a month for a couple hours, I am pretty happy with my progress. I think our next stitch together is tomorrow night, if I remember correctly. So how that works is if you go to Pam's channel, excuse me, I need a drink. Pam's channel, Stitching in the Land of Good Enough, I'll link it below. And she has a Google form in the description box for her videos. And you fill that out, and then between 12 and 24 hours, either the day before the Stitch Together or the morning of the Stitch Together, she sends out the link for the Zoom. If you think you might be interested, go ahead and sign up. I know the last one was really well attended, and she's thinking she may be getting close to the limit of how many people she can have on one session. So check it out. Sign up. I'm sure if she's got more people than she can accommodate, she'll let you know. She's really good about communicating. But yeah, check out her videos. She's, like I said, she's got a really nice variety of pieces, and she just makes me laugh. She shares with us the adventures at her bird feeders in her backyard. So, like I said, her channel name, Stitching in the Land of Good Enough. So that's all I've worked on. I'm pretty pleased with that, though, because I'm taking a couple college classes. Didn't expect to have much time at all for stitching. I was actually kind of hoping the two Thursday nights a month would give me an excuse to stitch, and I've had more time for that. Plans. What am I planning on doing? So I believe tomorrow night is Hawkrun Hollow. I'm going to stitch on that. Next week I'll be working from home, so I'll continue alternating between Renaissance and an open heart. Okay, guys, my phone, I got a new phone, and apparently it has a limit on how much it'll record at any one point in time. So there's going to be some sketchy editing here, and I apologize about that. So I was talking about plans. I'm going to do Hawkrun Hollow tomorrow night and the second stitch along. The fourth Thursday, I'm not sure what the date is. So tomorrow's the 8th, so that would be maybe the 22nd, whenever that is. So I'll do that. Hoping to work on the drawn thread piece in Renaissance if I have calls next week when I work from home. We'll see how that goes. And hope to get some other finishing FFOs done. I've got a ton of pieces that are waiting very patiently, some of them for a very long time to be finished. And I have a couple of ideas for two more pieces that I want to get to, hopefully, later this week or this weekend if I have time around class stuff. So more to come on that. I'm kind of excited about that. And since it's been almost a month since we visited, I have probably way more shopping than any one person should have, but I'll share some of it with you. I'm not going to show you all of it. I did get several Blackbird Designs pieces that I ordered. I think a lot of us did that when we lost Barb of Blackbird Designs, from Barb and Alma, the beginning of July. I went out and I have all of the loose feathers for the birds series now, I think. I have the last two ordered, and I think my order hasn't been canceled, so I think I can still get them. I have the whole Garden Club series, and then I've gotten all the other samplers and books so far that I've wanted to get. So I'll share just a few of those that I have, that I've gotten. Because they came with other pieces that I wanted to show you. I did an order from Silver Needle and Jen's Stitching Niche, so some of these came with that. So this one is one that I haven't seen a lot, but it is Blackbird Designs Raise a Glass of Cheer. Let's see. Yeah, so there's not a huge glare there. Let me see if I can get it closer for you. But I really like that one. I'm thinking about doing this for a New Year's Day start this year. Maybe New Year's Eve start, depending on what's going on. And then this is one of the For the Birds series. This one is The Light Upon the Lawn. Part of what I really liked about this series, I mean, I like birds, of course. But I also like the blues. Blue is my favorite color. So these all have a lot of blues in them. So there's that one. And this one is another Loose Feathers series. This was the Abecedarian series. They did several samplers. I didn't get all of these. Not that I dislike them, but they don't call to me so much. But this one is Bluebird of Happiness. And, you know, bluebird, blue house. You don't see a lot of blue houses in samplers. So this one came home. And the last Blackbird piece that I'm going to share with you is Merry Christmas Sampler. Again, this isn't a really new one. This one, I think this was maybe one of their first Christmas samplers. But it's just a really sweet little sampler. And it looks like it should be a fairly quick stitch. The stitch count on it is 77 by 140. Yeah, I'm famous for saying it should be a quick stitch. And, you know, I don't get there. I also picked up some Luminous Fiber Arts pieces. I'm sure some of you have seen this one. This one came out this summer. This is Gathering Clover. And it's a series. Misty Purcell from Luminous Fiber Arts, she started with Gathering Berries last summer that she released as a PDF on her Etsy shop. And that was a fundraiser for a family member who was having some medical issues. So this one she released as a printed chart. I'm not sure. You might be able to get a PDF on her Etsy shop. I didn't look. I just picked this one up. So they're the same size. So there's that one. And there's another one that I'll show you here shortly. But there's going to be one for each season. I think she said there's going to be five in the series on her last YouTube. So I'm glad there's going to be at least four, because I have an idea in my head for finishing them. Of course, I have to stitch them first. But I have an FFO idea that I'd like to try. So I'm kind of excited to have her release the fourth one, which I think will be the end of this month, October. I could be wrong. Maybe she didn't give us the date in her last floss tube. So then I can pick a piece of fabric that works with all the colors, get them stitched, and hopefully, you know, unveil my really cool FFOing idea if it comes out the way I hope. But I also got, this is, you know, along with birds, I'm kind of obsessed with squirrels these days, and it's autumn, and I love the colors in this, and it's two squirrels. This is Friendship Series Stashing Squirrels. And in her Friendship Series, she puts initials of her friends, and if you can see right here, there's an H and a D, and that is Helen D from Helen D on Flosstube. So I thought that was kind of cool. Helen is one of the first people that I found when I started watching Flosstube, so I feel like I know her. And it was cool to see her on that. And then this is the third chart in Misty's series. This is Gathering Acorns. And I have a couple other really cool autumn colored silks. I'll probably use one of those for this. And again, all of these gathering series, they're the same size, which is really good for the finishing that I want to do with it. They're 76 by 76. I don't see on the back here, I don't see the measurement, what that is, but they're all done on 32 count, which is not a bad size. And she does give options to do them. You can see this has buttons here. She does give you options to do them with or without the button on the chart on the inside. And in just in case one chart called Gathering Acorns is not enough, I ordered another one. This is Gathering Acorns, another really cool, really cute little squirrel. And this is by Cottage Garden Samplings. Sorry about that. And this is all DMC except for Gentle Arts Maple Syrup. But they do give a DMC alternative for that. And that's got to be somewhere in the squirrel. And this one, another one I'm thinking should be fairly quick. It's 100 by 130. So it's not a huge chart at all. This is a Prairie Schooler. I picked this up. This is this year's Prairie Schooler. I don't think there's a lot of glare there. And I blame this one on Laura from Stitching by the Shore. She's stitching, she has one or two of the Prairie Schooler Santas finished, and she's stitching another one, but she's doing them on Picture This Plus. I believe the color is Jade. It's a really pretty neutral type green, and it just makes the Prairie Schooler colors just pop. And she's got me inspired, so I got them. I don't know if I'll get the same fabric that she's using, but kind of opened up the possibilities for fabric, and I'll probably look at something. I've got a bunch of greens and different colors in my stash, so I'll be checking that out. And then this is a new chart. This was released at Expo. This is an Erica Michaels Holly Jolly Christmas. So I'm going to be doing the strawberries because, like I said, drums and strawberries. Maybe this will be my first strawberry finish. And she gives, there's what the top looks like, and she gives really good finishing instructions as well. I think I'm going to do, though, before I do one of these and try to cut my stitching, I'm going to do what Stacy, the 911 stitcher, suggested, and I'm going to make a couple strawberries from cotton fabric. I have a bunch of that in my stash, and I can use that. And if I make mistakes or make a wrong cut, it's not going to be a big deal, and I'll get the hang of how to make them. And then once I get to an actual stitched piece, I'll be more familiar with the process, and it should work pretty well. Another new piece, but back to the autumn theme, is October's Party by Little House Needleworks. If you can see that there. So this is a really cool piece, and it's mostly words, so I'm hoping it'll stitch pretty quick, but it's part of a poem by George Cooper. And the part that's on the chart says, October gave a party, the leaves by hundreds came, the chestnuts, oaks, and maples, and leaves of every name. The sunshine spread a carpet, and everything was grand. Miss Weather led the dancing, Professor Wind the band. So I don't know if I can get that close enough for you to read that, but it's a sweet little chart. And then the rest of the poem says, the chestnuts came in yellow, the oaks in crimson dressed. The lovely Mrs. Maple in scarlet looked their best. All balanced to their partners and gaily fluttered by, the sight was like a rainbow new fallen from the sky. Then as the rustic hollow all hide, then in the rustic hollow all hide and seek they played. The party ended at sundown and everybody stayed. Professor Wynn played louder, they flew along the ground, and then the party ended in jolly hands all around. And again, that's a poem by George Cooper. So cute little chart. Have no idea when I'll start that, but it's a good candidate for autumn stitching. And I picked up, this is a Teresa Cogut. It's called Two in a Bush, and it's birds. So that's kind of one of my things right now. But I like the, I don't know if they call it fractur painting style, almost like an Amish or Pennsylvania Dutch styling of this. So that should be a fun stitch. And two more pieces from Expo that I picked up. This is Heartstring Samplery, the HF1837 sampler. And there was a big glare there. Let me see if I can get you a better vision of this. Hold on. Yeah. Okay. Sorry about the glare. There we go. That's better. But what really got my attention is this bouquet of flowers in the middle. Can you see that? So, and this blue alphabet up here. So, again, another one. No idea when I'll start it. I think she's pretty big. She's 227 by 298. The model stick is stitched in NPIs, but she does give a DMC conversion, which is probably what I'll be doing. And then this piece down here, it's a reproduction. And there's really bad glare there. I'm sorry, guys. So this piece down here, the lower piece, that's the actual antique that she reproduced. And that's Heartstring Samplery from that. The last two pieces, this one is another Expo release. It's Summerhouse Stitchworks Winter Whites. Pull back here. So, hello, drum, right? Had to. And I got it fully kitted from Silver Needle, so it came with the linen, which is 32 count raw linen by Zweigart. And it's only three colors of DMC. So there, let's get that a little closer. It's a really sweet little drum. And the stitch count on it isn't too bad. 109 wide by 45 high. So, and I think I got the finishing kit, which comes with the this fabric for the top and the Lady Dot chenille. So that should be fun. I have a feeling I'll probably start that sooner rather than later. And the last chart that I got is, this is an older chart. I'm not sure what the copyright date on this is, and I'm sure you've seen a bunch of people stitching this. I can't read the small print with my hot contacts in, but this is Ye Old Crow by Heart and Hand. So I really love the color combination on this. I know I've seen a couple people stitching this too. I think maybe Cheryl stitched this from Tranquil Stitches on YouTube. She might be one of the people that finished this recently or has it as a whip. So I've got a couple different blacks in mind for this, and I do want to do it on a light tan fabric like that. I really like that color combination. Again, no firm plans on starting it, but it's one I've seen several times. And then I picked up some fabrics. I really have no business buying fabric. I looked at my stash, but there are a few colors that I've been wanting for a while, and I finally had an opportunity to get them. One of them is this Hog's Bristle. This is by Fox and Rabbit. Let me hold it up against a piece of white so you can kind of see. It's a really pretty neutral, but it's got almost a greenish cast to it. So this particular piece is 36 count, and I also got a piece of 32 count from another shop. And I'll link that shop below. It was an Etsy shop. I think it is Sugar Quilts or something like that. But this is a piece of 18 count Aida that I got from them. I think the light's kind of blowing this out. Let me see. It's kind of a really pretty winter white. It's not even an ivory, but this is Cream and Sugar. And then I got another piece of 18 count, which is, what is this one? It's also Fiber and Wind. This is Milk and Honey, which has a little bit of a tannish cast to it. Again, I think my lights are blowing it out tonight. You can see it against the white mat board. But it's, I haven't stitched with Fiber on a Whim, but I really like their fabrics. They feel really nice. I know a few other people have spoken highly of them. And then along with with a piece of 32 count Hogs Bristle, I got this Ancient Ruins, which is also Fox and Rabbit fabric. Really pretty gray. I'll pull it back here. It's darker than what I usually buy, but I think I've got some things that'll work nicely on that. And the last piece is, and this is the main reason that I ordered from them, they had ballet slippers, which people have been raving about, and I can see why. It's a really neutral, nice neutral pink, but it does have a pink tone to it. And the color literally does remind me of the ballet slippers I had the 1 year I took dance lessons. Anyone who has seen me and knows how coordinated I am not, and how I struggle with right and left, will understand why there was only one year of dance lessons. So, and I also picked up, I've got another favorite color here. This is called Winter Moon, and it's a standard Zweigart color. It's a nice, it's not really a tan, not really a yellow. It's kind of a really nice neutral, and it's not going to show up here real well. But I've got that, and I picked up Gentle Arts Cinders, and I have a plan, and that's not showing up real well. Let me see if it comes up, if I can get it closer. If you've ever seen Cinders, it's really pretty black and almost like a burgundy variegated. And I have a plan to do My Necessity by Heartstring Samplery on that, on that fabric with Cinders. And then I was poking around Etsy and I found this shop, and it is Sarah Jackson is the dyer, and her Etsy shop is jacksonfabricarts.com. I'm going to get her card up here so you can see it. I hope that focuses. There's her shop. And what excited me about her fabric and made me want to try it, most linen is made from flax. And she deals with fabric, linen type fabrics. They're 30 count fabric, but it's made from hemp. So I was really curious about that. So this color is London Fog, and this kind of really got my attention too. Look at that modeling. It's really pretty. It's like a cocoa brown and gray modeling. And the edges come, she does a real nice thin zigzag on the edges so they're not going to fray. So I picked up that, and it feels really nice. Feels really rather comparable. Sorry, my pile fell over here. Feels pretty comparable to a piece of Zweigart linen. Not exactly the same, but pretty close. And then the other piece I got is this. It's called Carrie. Let's see if I can show it to you without it blowing out. It's a really pretty light green, almost a neutrally kind of green. So depending on how things work out, how the colors show on this, I may use this for Satsuma's mystery sampler, their Mystery Noel sampler. I signed up for that, and I think the first part's supposed to come out soon. I forget exactly when it's starting, but I haven't done a floss toss yet, but my thought is to use that. She said her colors are a little bit modern, so that might work nice. And of course, last but not least, it's that time of year. It's the Just Cross Stitch ornament issue. I'm not going to do a flip through. I'm sure lots of folks are, but I will show you a couple of my favorite ornaments from here. The first one is, what'd she call it? Noel Angel by Rosewood Manor. This one down here. She uses some of my favorite series of DMCs, the 920 colors, that real nice dusty teal. I love those colors. So there's that one. And then I love cardinals. That cardinal up there is calling to me too. That is by, I'm not sure. What number is that? Number 7. That is Laurel Susan Studio. So that one's nice. But my favorite ornament, and I think this is just adorable, is here. And it is Holly and Ivy by... Bear with me. The Holly and the Ivy by Cherry Parker. And it is... Let's see if I can get you a good picture of it. It is this cute little stack of biscornus right there. Can you get a good look at that? So you stitch the 3 biscornus and you make them individually. They're graduated sizes, and then you stack them together. So that should be fun. And there's not a lot of stitching in them. You stitch the corners, the 4 corners, and then, of course, the edging to be able to do the biscornu. So hopefully I'll get a start on that. Maybe I'll have that to share with you soon. So that's my shopping. Heaven knows that's plenty, right? But I do have a giveaway. So I bought a second issue of this. And if you guys remember when I gave the 2 Halloween issues away, that was because there was a shipping mistake. So I have an issue of the 2021 Just Cross Stitch Ornaments issue that I will send to someone who wants it. Please be 18 so you can give me your address legally. You know, the usual rules apply. Please don't say free. Please don't say giveaway. But please, and I would love it if you were a subscriber, but honestly, I'm not going to check. So leave me a comment and use the word ornaments. And in 2 weeks, so today is October 7th, so the 21st, I will use the YouTube random comment generator picker, and I will pick a winner and do at least a short video announcing the giveaway winner if I don't have a full video to do that night. So leave me a comment if you're interested. And other than that, quick life update. There's not a lot going on. I've got college classes going on. I have a final I have to take. Some of my classes are half a semester long. And the first one of those is ending. I finished up my final paper. I've got a final that's due on Sunday. My economics class runs the entire semester, and then I'll start 2 new classes next Monday. So I'm kind of excited about that, but the workload's going to pick up a little bit, but should be okay. Other than that, in the U.S., some of you might have a long weekend coming up. I'm thinking about taking Monday off. My husband's taking Monday off. If the weather's decent, hopefully we'll be able to get, you know, one of our last motorcycle rides of the season in. It's getting to be that time of year when we don't know how many more days we're going to have left to ride. So that's exciting. Also, he's retiring the end of next month, the end of November. So that's kind of exciting, kind of scary. You know, we'll see where things go, but he's getting everything in order for that. And that's about it. So I hope you're all happy. I hope you're well. Hope you're getting lots of stitching time or whatever crafting you choose to do. And until next time, I'll say see ya. Bye.